Hello, welcome to Rayman 3 again. I have a guest.
You do? That is me.
It is you. Hey. So yeah, this is the second time we're doing this because my nan interrupted me. She said she was going. I thought she'd already left. No. Anyway, so yeah, Rayman 3 again. Why am I doing this again? I did it with my oldest recording method. I did it with my older recording method. Now I'm doing it with the best recording method. But there is a twist with this one. This is going to be a more in-depth playthrough sort of thing. It is going to show everything, and not just everything, every beta thing, every beta picture, every information that isn't well known, every secret, everything. I will have everything done in this game. In case you missed it, I'm doing everything. Oh yeah, funny stuff. Yeah, that too. Yeah, that was the first one. Everything. Okay, moving on.
There's a lot to look forward to.
Yeah, so how far have you ever got in this game? Was it the desert of the Kanara?
I don't think I got past the land of the living dead. I'm not sure whereabouts I ended there, but I don't think I got anywhere past
Which
that.
Was your favourite level out of the ones you did?
Either the one where you're in the swamp.
Oh, the Bog of Murk, yeah.
That's it, or the first one. Where you're
very clearly forest.
Okay. That one.
Yeah, okay, fine. Right, I'm just going to say this now. Any beta music I list will be at the end of the video, because I will actually play them so you hear them. Now, first one I'm going to mention, beta music for the main menu screen was actually very, very, very different. It was actually a remix of one of the themes from the Bog of Murk, a shortened version, but which is quite interesting. Another theme, they made for the game was called Off We Go. It's completely unknown as to where it was going to be, as it had no resemblance to any of the worlds at all. Another piece was called Hurry Up, and again unknown as to where it would go, as it seems to have a piece of every single world's theme incorporated into it, so it's kind of weird, and I couldn't tell you where that would go. Let me assign slots. Oh, it's already on 6, that's good. How do we do this? L teal? I've only got 5 letters.
Okay.
L teal will do. That's the best I can get, to be honest. So yeah.
L teal.
L teal. Le teal. yeah.
That sounds really French. Le teal.
A tad French. Another one was called For Whom the Bells Toll. Again, that's unknown as to where it could go, but it sort of resembles Hoodlum Headquarters a bit, so I'm going to say there. Another one is called Grinding Gears. Again, also unknown as to where it would go, but I think, again, Hoodlum Headquarters, it has that sort of feel. However, it's more ambience than an actual song. It's more sound effect stuff. And then finally, the music for the trailer of the game, which is classed as bass and music, was, just put it simply, weird. Really weird, but at the same time quite catchy. Like the others, I will put it at the end of the video, just so you will know. So yeah. Now some random Rayman trivia stuff. Apart from the plot here where a red lum is a black lum, and whenever a red lum is scared, it turns into a black lum, and they're evil stuff. But yeah, the land or planet that Rayman is in is called the Glade of Dreams. In Rayman 3 and the French release of Rayman 2, actually, it's called the Crossroads of Dreams. For some reason. There is no map of this land for Rayman 3. However, there is a map for the Glade of Dreams for Rayman 1, 2, and Origins. Yes, they've released a map for Origins. So they will appear about now-ish. The Glades planet has 2 moons, one of which is seen as larger than the other. These can be seen more prominently in certain points of this game and Rayman 1. However, there are points in both Rayman and Rayman 2 during which they appear to only have 1 moon. So it's kind of debatable how many there are. The Fairy Council and the Heart of the World, which is the first world of this game, was first mentioned in Rayman 2, but only now makes an appearance. So now some interesting, funny trivia. When you start hitting Glowbox, sometimes he says you were nicer in Rayman 2, which is just really funny.
I didn't even know that.
I'm going to try and see if I can make him do it. There are a lot of secret rooms in the game, but three of them refer to Rayman 2. One, located in the longest shortcut, has a statue of Lee within it. Another in the Hoodlum headquarters has statues of Razorbeard and some of his pirates or henchmen sitting at a table in the style of The Last Supper, the painting by Leonardo da Vinci. Also in Razulf's mansion, is it Razulf or Razulf? Anyway, his mansion, one of the many different statues is a snake, which appears to be Sam, the snake from Rayman 2. So I will be showing them off in great detail. I will get onto more stuff in a second, but first we got this and I've already failed. Excellent. Basically, the way to progress here. The way to progress here is you have to get all the red lambs, and then you can progress. That's basically it. Just in case you didn't know. Yeah, thanks, Murphy. Try not to fail so miserably this time. I am trying. You have no idea.
Oh, man. I remember one level. I forget which one it is, but it drove me mad.
Could you describe it?
No, I don't remember. I just remember getting really annoyed with it.
I imagine I can imagine. Was it Livid Dead? Were there loads of enemies? Was it sort of really bright, sort of bluish area? Really bright.
Yeah, that was
Livid Dead. Must be. That area is quite hard, I'm not gonna lie. It's like, hey, Bog of Murk was relative difficulty increased. Hey, let's throw you onto the deep end now. Because why not? It just does get a bit harder. There's something quite interesting. At the beginning of the third part of the Fairy Council, when Rayman and Murphy are looking for Andre and Grobox, Murphy tells Rayman to hurry up or he'll start telling everyone he's your father. This is, of course, a reference to Star Wars 5. Emperor Strikes Back, which is just awesome. But it's got a 30% chance of actually saying it, so good luck hearing him say it. Of course, unfortunately, Elman will not be able to hear everything that the characters say, because he's just going to have to be able to listen to music through just a website, because I can't actually allow him to listen to it without either doing post-commentary or it having doubled the audio, so yeah, unfortunately. It's sad.
I know. But I always find that live commentary always comes out better than post.
Yeah, live commentary does. In the Fairy Council, which is the place we are now, when Rayman and Murphy pursue Andre and encounter the Ludiv? Anyway, and the Dark Lumblord throws the fairy away from her home, saying Zelda needs her before hiding in Ludiv's home. Which is a reference to The Legend of Zelda, which is awesome.
Oh man, I didn't even know any of these existed.
Yeah, some of these are quite hard to find. In the Vault of Murk, inside Razulf's house, is a room with a large mirror. If Rayman is left in idle in front of it, he'll make a face of himself and notice he has something stuck in his teeth and pulling it out. There is some really interesting stuff I bet you never knew about this game, and I'm going to teach you all of them. So yeah, basically, I can't hit this guy. Basically, if you missed it, you got to get combo points. You get different combos if you get stuff. Say you get one of these gems now, and then get another one at the bottom. The combo meter grows and grows and grows. If you get a certain amount, it doubles. And then doubles again. However, if you have a power up, it doubles again automatically. So if there's a secret area and there's a power up near it, get the power up before actually attempting to, you know, get the secret and stuff. But that should be self-explanatory. You don't actually need to go there because it's just health. You should have full health on the first bit of the level because you get it pretty much instantly anyway. It just gets given to you on a platter. So yeah. That's nice. Do you remember any of this?
Yes. Yes, I do.
Good. That's good to know, then. Yeah, that is nice. Isn't that lovely?
It truly is.
It truly is just wonderful and magical and new and brilliant and fantastic and amazing.
It warms the cockles of my heart.
Oh, does it now? Oh, that's deep.
I used to watch that show. Oh, it's Sonic Sat AM or something.
Yes, Sat AM. That is the term.
That was what it was. That was quite good.
It was a brilliant series. I do like it. I love the voice of Snivelling. Yes, We're beginning to get in range of the hedgehog. Yes, master.
Yeah, he was good. He was good.
Yeah.
They all had their like. Wait. They all had their pros.
I'm trying to figure out what's the zoom button. Is it
R3, isn't it?
Yes, it might be actually. No, is it select?
I remember you could do a camera mode. There it is, the camera mode.
No way, that's not it. No, what are you doing?
You just saved a picture that you didn't mean to take.
I don't know how to do it. Won't let me do it. Oh, it's triangle. Wow.
Wow, there you go. Really?
Yeah. That's the one thing I never do in this game, zoom into things, but now I will start to, because there is actually the blue and red creatures of the land, and they basically give you points if you zoom into them, and I never knew that for the longest time, and by longest time I mean I found that out today, so, because I always wondered what they were there for. I knew they gave you points, but I had no idea how, so, yeah. I love how Murphy just... I don't know if it's Muffy or Murphy. I think it's both, because he's pronounced twice in two different ways in Rayman 2 and in Rayman 3, so it's debatable what his actual name is.
I always called him Murphy.
Yeah, I call him both. I switch between the two. It's kind of weird. But, oh well. Yay. I love this game. Oh, jazz, the jazzy theme sort of starts. Oh, I love that. Oh. Oh, it's so good. And here is our Lord and Master Glowbox.
It explains the switch's trigger mechanism. Duh. Police. Who's responsible for this garbage?
Some more interesting news. Well, not news, more trivia. Spiral doors from Rayman 2 have been replaced with mirrors in this game. So, you know, you used to go through spiral doors to get to levels.
Yeah.
Well, you basically get through them with mirrors now. Just so you know, another piece of interesting trivia, this one more recent news, but pretty much all the Rayman 3 artwork has been used for reference for Rayman Origins.
Really?
Yes, it has. Which is quite interesting, which means it's going to be awesome! Okay, so, yeah, that's pretty much all I can say. The game will just be generally amazing.
I am looking forward to Origins.
I am too. It's gonna be great. I think I'm looking forward to Skyrim and Zelda more, though, because those games are great.
I'm looking more... I have to say, I'm looking more forward to Sonic Generations than Rayman Origins.
Yes, I am too. I am too, I must say that. In this game, in the PS2 and PC version, there were 9 minigames. However, before I go on to that, the last one requires you to have collected over 300,000 points throughout the game. However, the GameCube version has an extra minigame. I can't remember which one it's replaced with. It doesn't have 10 minigames. I'm pretty sure it only has 9, maybe 8, and it's replaced something else. I don't know which. But it's called Mad Tracks, and you can actually, it requires you to complete a sort of track thing with Rayman's shoe. You have to play it this way. You have to play it with the Game Boy Advance version of Rayman 3, and the Game Boy Advance version of Rayman 3 basically puts the track together. Why can't I get through this door? Okay, there we go. Yeah, the Game Boy Advance version puts the track together for you, which is quite interesting.
That's pretty cool.
Let me go on to the biggest secret of the game. It is a hidden door outside the final boss, which is that only opens up if you achieve Murphy's score for each world. If you say get 100 less than the actual score you need, and then get 100 more in the next world, doesn't matter. You have to get the more than the amount for that specific world. So it's quite strict in that respect. But yeah, it's called the Xowar Secret. And it contains an unidentified bird. You know the creature that you saw in the intro? The thing that lost all its fur?
Yeah.
It's called a Morpaw, and it's a blue version of that in this secret, and it has an unreleased character called the Xowar. Also, it has 4 green gems, which are worth 1,500 points, which is pretty good, I think. If I don't get the recommended amount per world, I will come back here later off camera, because it's pointless doing it on camera. The score for this world is 20,821, so I must get more than that, if I can. So yeah, I'm gonna try my- oh, that thing blocked me. I'm gonna try my hardest to beat that score. If I don't, I'll just do it off camera and try and get a better score. So, yeah, because I will get the secret, because I don't know how many people have actually done that. For some reason, it's the camera wasn't fixed on me. It's kind of annoying.
Go for it, Rayman,
you can do it. Yeah, this part's basically just explaining different things, but after that, it'll be more interesting, because we'll be making more jokes.
Yay!
Jokes!
I love amusement.
I do too. There was a theme that was unused, not a beta theme, it was just an unused theme. There's a difference. And it is called the Ice Dance, and it's from Edward Scissorhands. And I think it was going to be in this world, the Fairy Council, because it sort of it has choir effects, so it sort of fits. So yeah.
There's something you didn't know. What could
this be? Yeah, and as always, it'll be at the end of the part. So. Yeah. Combat fatigue. That's exactly what we need. It is, isn't it? Right. Yes.
Rayman, indeed.
No! It belongs to the hoodlums. It might be dangerous. What are you trying to
it might be incredibly dangerous. So dangerous it could kill us all.
Ladies and gentlemen, buy your nuke in a can.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's a tornado in a can, actually.
Very stunning.
The bright light could have fooled me. How it
works. Yeah. No, the nuke in a can is later on. So don't worry, you are nearly right. Better destroy it's good to destroy these platforms with this because they do give you 30 points and it's a combo and did you see it?
Oh wow.
Got ya. I got the blue thing.
That's something.
I got 48%, that's not great. Anyway, I got a lot to do in this world, but there are secrets. So yeah. There's going to be some reading for you later, and it's called the TNC Highway, which you're going to have to explain because I'll be concentrating on the TNC Highway.
Woohoo!
So you get to read!
I love educating people.
It is grand, isn't it? Isn't it just divine? Isn't it the most divinest thing you've ever done in your entire life?
It makes you feel above all the other people who don't know the things you do.
I know, isn't it just marvellous? Marvellous, I tell you, marvellous.
Yeah, alright, calm down.
Maybe not that marvellous, but it's marvellous nevertheless.
You haven't even got past the first level, you're already going insane.
Yeah.
Woo.
Wait a minute, camera. Whoa, that was interesting. I seem to remember a red thing, a red bug thing, but maybe I'm mistaken, maybe it's not here. Actually, I don't think it is. I think it's later, actually. Or maybe it is here, and I've just missed it. Oh well, if I miss one or two, it doesn't matter too much. Vo's the one thing- oh, it's over there, that's silly me, right there. Yeah, you gotta make sure you don't get too close to it, because if you wake it up, you lose. And there it is, look at it.
Aww. It's so cute.
Gotta make sure I don't wake it up. Got ya! You can either stare at it or just walk up to it. And you gotta make sure you don't wake it up. If it wakes up, you don't get a point. I think the last one I didn't actually get it. But that one I did, so that's okay. So I definitely got points from it. You all saw it! I got the points! I got the points! So many points! Anyway.
It's okay.
I'm going to tell you so many secrets you didn't know about this game. There are so many. I'm not even joking.
Oh my god, what is going on here? Would you mind being a bit more quiet?
No.
Bug off, Harry! Zelda needs you!
There it is.
Watching this with no sound is quite funny because you can interpret whatever you want them to be saying.
Yeah. I imagine it was. Okay, I think the Zelda thing always appears, I can't remember. I've just never heard it. But yeah, it's the Zelda thing. Which is awesome. I normally go for this one last. I don't know why I'm going for it first. Oh well. Yeah.
Enough with the noise already!
I'm the cleaning lady, can I take a message?
Don't let him escape!
Oh.
Is that you, Mary Lou?
Is that you, Mary Lou?
Yes.
Oh my god, he's got the strength of 10! 1,000!
Oh, no he's not. He's dead.
Oh my god, it's an unspeakable atrocity! Andre is gonna reach the horn! It's the end of the world!
Thank you for opening the door. The door to darkness, except no darkness is here.
Quite false advertising, really.
Yeah.
I mean, when I get a door for darkness, I don't know about you guys, but I want my darkness.
Yeah, I want darkness, but darkness will not. You will not get any darkness, I'm sorry. You refuse for you to have darkness inside your heart.
Over here, Rayman! Emmanuel says it can go up here!
Okay.
Hey, there we go.
I'd call it quits and head straight for the Spider-Man 2 audition.
Nah. Yeah, Maybe just said you should call it quits and head straight for the Spider-Man 2 audition. little did he know, after Spider-Man 2 was going to be shit. Oh well.
I haven't seen Spider-Man 3. Is it really that bad?
Yes. Oh god, what are you missing? A lot. And it's actually, no, you're not missing anything. Don't ever see it. It is awful.
Is it that bad, though?
Yeah, the only good bit is the end, when there's actually a decent fight scene. The rest is awful in every single way. Don't see it. For the love of God, don't see it. I'm not even joking. Please, don't burden yourself with it.
Two things that I've missed out on. Sonic 06 and Spider-Man 3. Woo-hoo.
Don't play Sonic 06. Please.
The more people tell me not to play it, the more I want to play it. It's the problem, because I want to see if it's really that bad.
Fine, play it at your own risk. You will cry.
I might see if there's a demo or something. And
I don't
give
think there
that.
Is.
It's because they knew if you played the demo, you wouldn't buy the
actually,
whole game.
Actually, no, there was a demo. There was a demo, I think, at the E3 conference that they had for it. And actually, the demo looked good. The level that actually came out wasn't, but the demo itself looked rather nice and good and wonderful and fantastic, and the fly slash mosquito is near me again and it's trying to bite me.
Deck him!
I would kill him, but I'm trying to concentrate on not dying. Sucks that.
Rayman!
Lobart, hey! Hello. Well done, Glowbox.
What a clever maneuver from Glowbox to try and stop the hoodlum with his fatness.
Yeah, with his mouth. A genius idea. Genius, if only I'd thought of it. If only. Yes. If only.
Mm-hmm.
Oh god, it's the jazz music of epicness. I love the jazz music of epicness.
The heart of the world.
Now, there is a secret here. Do you see this platform right here? Welcome to the first proper secret of the game. And by proper secret, I mean Rayman. First proper secret of the game. Here, you can get up here. Hit this, it is a button. It opens this door of death.
Oh, wow.
It's not really a door of death, but it's a door nevertheless. And watch this. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah, so many gems, so many, and as a result, our bonus is 6,570.
Oh my.
The yellows are worth 10, the red gems are worth 30, green, 1,500. If you can get tons of gems before the green, do it. It is the only way you're going to be able to beat Murphy's score. The only way.
Oh, you idiots! Just what I thought.
Andre isn't dead!
We can't keep Globox near the heart. It's too risky.
It's too risky. He's so fat.
Easy, Craig. Take him to the witch doctor in Clearly Forest.
Seriously, how is he not dead? He's got the strength of 20,000.
He and I go way back. He'll know how to get rid of Andre.
Right.
Look out, Rayman. Andre is a black lum, and black lums are twisted.
Black lums are twisted. Maybe. Yes, they are. Globox, they are. They
drink plum juice. And we all know Globox is
allergic to plum juice. Oh, we all know that, yes. See you in Rayman 4. Okay, Murphy, see ya. Right, on to TNT Highway. Oh, levels go 100%. Oh, yeah. If you don't go into that secret, you get 0%, which is kind of annoying. So if you don't know about it, you are confused.
Thank you. Bye.